BlackRock, the world's largest asset manager, and luckily for us, a publicly traded company that has a stellar track record. But is this still a good buy today? Stick around to find out. Hey everyone, Stock Ninja here. This is episode 18 of Who Beat the S&P 500. We will be headed back to the financial sector to take a look at BlackRock Incorporated. The financial sector has been weak since the March lows compared to the overall market, and I'm always on the hunt for a good deal. Stick around till the end of the video to find out my plans for BlackRock stock. For now, let's dive in. BlackRock was founded in 1988 by Robert S. Kapito and Lawrence D. Fink. Initially a risk management and fixed income institutional asset manager, BlackRock is now the world's largest asset manager with $7.4 trillion in assets under management. Today, BlackRock is an international company operating with 70 offices in 30 countries and clients in over 100 countries. Let's see what kind of returns BlackRock would have given you had you held their shares over the last 20 years. Had you invested $10,000 into BlackRock exactly 20 years ago, with dividends reinvested, you would have a small cottage worth $210,725.47 versus the $33,434.72 of the S&P. That's a 2,005.51% total return, beating the returns of the S&P's 234.04% by over 8 times, which comes out to an average annual return of 16.46% versus a 6.22% of the S&P in the same time frame. BlackRock stock doing BlackRock-like things and growing immensely. If you're enjoying the content, don't forget to destroy that like button and subscribe to the channel. BlackRock has a market cap of around $91 billion, making it a large cap company. BlackRock is listed within the financial services sector with an industry focus of asset management. Currently trading with the ticker symbol BLK on the New York Stock Exchange, BlackRock is a member of the S&P 100 and S&P 500 indexes. With the quarterly dividend distribution, BlackRock typically pays their dividend during the months of March, June, September, and December. BlackRock currently has a decent dividend yield of 2.44%, which comes out to an annual payout of $14.52. Which seems like a lot, but keep in mind that the stock is currently trading near the $600 range as of this recording. The payout ratio is a healthy 48.58%, which should keep it sustainable. Lastly, when looking at the dividend safety score on SimpliSafe Dividend, we can see an overall score of 98 out of 99, which is considered very safe and just 1 point shy of a perfect score. Looking at BlackRock's dividend growth, we can see that they have been growing their dividend for 11 consecutive years, with an uninterrupted dividend streak of 17 years without a reduction. The dividend was unchanged from 2008 to 2009 during the financial crisis. Also, when considering the dividend growth, it has been fantastic, with a 10-year CAGR or compound annual growth rate of 15.52%, the 5 and 3 year CAGRs at double digits as well, and a bit of a slowdown during the 1 year CAGR at 8.90%. BlackRock is a fantastic stock for a dividend portfolio. The dividend is quite safe, growth has been phenomenal, and could boost the overall returns of a portfolio given their stock appreciation. BlackRock's fiscal year runs from January through December each year and is currently in fiscal year 2020. As fiscal year 2020 is not yet complete, we will look at their 2019 annual report. In fiscal year 2019, BlackRock generated $14.88 billion in revenue. When looking back from 2015, we can see that revenue has been on the up. A huge jump in revenue of over 22% from 2016 to 2017. Revenue has since gone up around 4% the last 2 years. Revenue is going up in general, which is what we as investors like to see. And a large part of that is due to their technology services, which I will discuss more about in a bit. BlackRock currently has a PE ratio of 20.39 and a forward PE ratio of 17.72, which would indicate revenue growth going forward. When looking at BlackRock's balance sheet, there are a few things I found interesting, starting with their current assets. Their current assets has hovered around $8 to $9 billion range from 2016 to 2019, while the total current liabilities has been hovering around $1.1 to $1.2 billion, which is also good, as a company can cover expenses in the short term. They also have very little long-term debt, which has hovered around $5 billion over the last few years. BlackRock has been steadily buying back shares as well, about $1.66 billion worth over the last 2 years, with a significant jump from 2017 to 2018, providing further value to shareholders. Overall, the balance sheet is looking solid. So how exactly is BlackRock making money? BlackRock operates under just one reportable segment. Under this operating segment, BlackRock serves a diverse mix of institutional and retail clients around the globe, with a combined total of $7.4 trillion in assets under management. Assets under management, or AUM for short, stands for total market value of the investments that a person or entity manages on behalf of clients. BlackRock generally earns this revenue by offering the following services: investment management fees, typically as agreed upon percentages of the AUM, performance fees on certain portfolios relative to the benchmark or return level, offering investment management systems, risk management, outsourcing and other technology services for a fee, and advising global financial institutions, regulatory and government entities on a range of risks, regulatory, capital markets, and strategic topics. Let's see how they break down their AUM. Starting with retail, BlackRock serves retail investors globally through a wide array of vehicles across the investment spectrum. Retail represented 10% of long-term AUM as of December 31, 2019, and 31% of long-term base fees for 2019. As many of you probably know, BlackRock owns the popular iShares ETFs, which consists of $2.2 trillion of assets under management. iShares ETFs represent 33% of long-term AUM as of December 31, 2019, and 41% of long-term base fees for 2019. Next is institutional. BlackRock serves institutional investors on six continents and subcategories, including pensions, endowments, and foundations, official institutions, and financial institutions. This is further broken down into institutional active and institutional index, which combined comes out to a $3.9 trillion in assets under management, representing 57% of long-term AUM as of December 31, 2019, and accounted for 28% of long-term base fees for 2019. Lastly, I want to revisit their technology services that they offer, especially Aladdin. Aladdin is BlackRock's end-to-end investment platform that combines sophisticated risk analysis with a slew of other tools. They also recently acquired eFront in 2019, which is an end-to-end alternative investment management software and solutions provider. With these two solutions combined, BlackRock saw an amazing 24% growth in technology services revenue. I'm expecting them to really expand in this department and continue to power their revenue growth. Now, let's see how the company fared in the dot-com bubble crash, the great financial recession, and how it's currently trading during the downturn in 2020. BlackRock fell 35.95% during the dot-com bubble crash, falling about 14% less than the S&P's 50.41% decline. BlackRock held up quite well during the dot-com bubble crash. During the great financial crisis, BlackRock fell 64.37%, dropping about 7% more than the 57.61% decline by the S&P. This wasn't as surprising to me given that BlackRock is a financial company and most financial institutions got hammered in 08 and 09. During the downturn in 2020, BlackRock fell 43.48% compared to the S&P's roughly 35.59% decline. Once again, most of the financial sector was hit pretty hard in 2020, and a lot of the companies have yet to fully recover. BlackRock is a nice contrast to that trend. Though the stock fell more than the S&P overall, they recovered faster and also went on to make new all-time highs, surpassing their former peak in January of 2018. During recessions, BlackRock has had decent drawdowns, but has recovered nicely not long afterwards. Investors should expect a lot of volatility with the company, but those who are patient and can stomach the fluctuations can reap some great rewards. Headquartered in New York City with around 16,200 full-time employees worldwide, BlackRock is currently led by Chairman, CEO, and co-founder of BlackRock, Lawrence Douglas Fink. Fink currently leads an executive leadership team of 19 members. Going through their bios, about one-third of them have been with the company since the 1990s, another one-half joining more recently anywhere from 2015 to the present, and a few in between. That is the kind of balance I like to see in a management team, maintaining a core team of veterans, but not being afraid to bring in new talent to the table. And obviously for BlackRock, it has been working quite well. Taking a quick look at the stock performance under Fink, we can see a phenomenal return of over 4,600%. Fink knows what he's doing, and no doubt surrounded himself with very talented people to help run his company. Looking at the institutions that currently hold BlackRock stock, we have Temasek Holdings Limited coming in at 5th place with a 3.90% stake in the company. In 4th, we have State Street with a 4.25% stake. And in 3rd place, we have Capital World Investors with a slightly higher 4.62% stake in BlackRock. Now, what is interesting is that BlackRock themselves has a 6.55% stake and comes in at second place. Remember, this is fairly common when looking at financial institutions and them holding their own stock. Lastly, we have Vanguard in first with an 8.5% stake in BlackRock, which equals just over $7 billion in value. So what are some of the risk factors when investing in BlackRock? Something that people might overlook is that as BlackRock has trillions of dollars in assets under management, they are more sensitive to regulatory trends and public policy developments than the average company. Any missteps there, and that could potentially cost shareholders a lot of money. Also, given all the financial information and standing, BlackRock will always be under threat of cybersecurity related risks. With cyber threats becoming larger by the day, the company will always have to be on their toes to keep up. In my opinion, overall, BlackRock is a very well-run company that is being led by a co-founder and a few of their fellow co-founders. They also have a solid dividend, have been buying back shares to boost EPS for shareholders, and have continued to push boundaries by investing in technological advances for their existing tools. So currently, I own quite a bit of financial stocks, and honestly, I feel this is the time to be loading up given the sector has been depressed most of 2020. From my analysis and research of BlackRock, I'm really liking what I see with the company. I feel like BlackRock is one of those stocks where you buy it and forget it, and I wouldn't mind opening a position sometime soon. Yes, we are near all-time highs, but my plan is to just dollar cost average over a period of time and let it just grow naturally. What do you guys think about BlackRock? That concludes our analysis of BlackRock Inc. If you made it thus far, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. It really helps out a small channel like mine. Thanks for watching, everyone. Till next time, Stock Ninja out.